Alright, so here it is. We do have some replacement capacitors arrived from a local supplier, so we have to pay an outrageous amount. Okay. So these are 3300 picofarads, and we're going to replace two of them that are here. Sorry, one that's here, but we're going to put two of them. Somehow we will make it more reliable, I guess. So, like an idiot, I did put a wrong value in there, thinking it will be fine, which is a bad thing to do. Okay. So that guy there, he needs to go. Do I have a double tweezer? Let me see. Double. I think I should be able to just yank that out. I don't want to apply heat because the keyboard is still on the bottom or on the other side. Okay. Which may cause a burn, or melt the plastic, etc. Try removing this. So let's bring these two capacitors, see if they will also explode or not. Okay. Okay, so now they're in. Let me check if there is a short. So we're in diode mode already. So that is bad. To ground. Yeah, give me 1 second, please. Okay, so it was a mistake on my part to replace that with an incorrect value, so that's 006. That's 001. Maybe there is no short, let me check the resistance. To ground, 7 ohms. Okay. Hard to know. We got the power supply set up from the other Intel NUC job, but I will put the voltage to 1 volt, amp to 1 amp. Okay, power on. Which is this guy here. Voltage 2 volts, voltage 5 volts, voltage 10 volts, 19 volts. Amp, say 3 amps. I don't think my mind is together at the moment. Yeah, I am a total douchebag, yes. Okay. That's the 19 volt rail. shunt resistor. To ground. Okay, we have a short on the main power rail. Okay. It's the same issue. Okay, so it's either that issue or something else also has gone off. Find out. Okay. So just ran a wire there. Okay, so let's see if I screw up. Let's see if I can fix this up. I shouldn't use the wrong size capacitor, which is a bad mistake to do. Okay, it's actually a rookie mistake. Can't believe it. Okay. Okay. Let's see. 0.6. It is not going anywhere. Let me check the ground. It's good. 0.7. Nothing. Let me check around the area which I already replaced. Capacitor 4, which is that one there. Nope, 0.7, nothing. Nothing, okay. Being a pick of ferrites, so the resistance will be quite low, eh, for that guy. Let me check. See if I can get a resistance reading of this capacitor here. What am I doing? Okay, what do we get in diet mode? Should charge it up. This is the capacitance mode. Wow, look at that, 3.2 nanofarads, which is 3300 picofarads. So that's actually good. How about on board? Hmm. you know what? Let me remove one of the caps. I will put two. That's the shunt resistor I removed. Okay, so I did kill... I did kill a MOSFET on the other side. Is it dead? I don't know. Maybe not. How about him? Okay, that's all train. Source to gate, that's fine. How about here? How about this guy? Okay, how about here to ground? So where the hell is the short? What, this guy? Let's see if there is any short activity there. One second. 0.82. No, nothing. No. No, nothing. This has been a bad experience for me. Okay. Unless something wrong with these guys, maybe. It's 350 ohms. Which is the BQ chip? Oh, okay, here we go. So that guy there is going to be GO553 VD. charger VCC, correct, R8812, 22 ohm resistor. And where do I find the 22 ohm resistor? Before that, so that's the size 0805. Now we finally have a resistor book for it. 22 ohms. Okay, wonderful. Okay, wonderful. Okay, what's the resistance of our main power rail now? To ground. Yeah. 28 ohms. That's shit and bad, okay. Let's bring in that guy. Alright, let's check the resistance now. What am I supposed to do with such a weird system here? Okay. So let's go back to potentially doing short testing, injecting 0.8. Let's bring it down to 0.6. We got a ground, that's there. Remove that. 0.6 answer is nothing. This is the weirdest fucking system ever. Okay. You know what? I suspect those two may have also died. Okay. Let's go back there. Okay, let's check. This is where the 19 volt rail is. To ground. I've never seen a weird behavior like this, jumping. That is the strangest thing ever, okay? Maybe this guy is touching multiple rails. Let me remove that. Okay. To ground. Yeah, so that's same as here. Okay, let's just remove these two. That's taking a long time to pull out. There's still a short. Okay. Okay, which one of you fuckers is still having short? Let's isolate at this point. Okay, that guy there. Okay. Maybe this guy's gone. 735 BQ 735. All right. Okay, let's check. All right, that's better. Short up there is gone. Okay. Now, let's start to bring all the components back. Here, 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 here. Okay. It's not really technically my fault. It's definitely there are other issues with this guy. Hello, SureCanDo speaking. Okay, let's go ahead, bring all... Now, from experience, I mean from chatting with many people, they recommend replacing the MOSFETs after such events, because there's a chance that they may be damaged. Let's see. Okay, let's just check now to ground to here. Hard to tell at this stage. Now let's put the user did say that their charger and the technician's charger was keep making a clicking sound. Okay, great. Now, yeah. we don't have a short yet. Now we must put that replacement chip, and before that, let's see. It's okay. Now this is the 737, wasn't it? 735. BQ 735. BQ735. I've got only one. Why? Should order more. 358 is the position. He's the last one of its kind. He's unique. We lose him, we're fucked. Okay. So that's the potentially bad one, but we're not sure. Can't really see clearly, is that okay or not? Okay. So the way this will go, like that. Okay. The trick is to have a low volume of air at maximum temperature, that's fine. Beautiful. There we go. Okay, and now moment of truth. So we don't have a short. Okay. So if we go back to this side where our chip was keep burning or getting damaged, there, let's put a replacement there. And we'll get a new one out. All right. Okay, done. Out of curiosity. Hey, look at that. All right, that's good. Now here is the moment of truth to see if this thing is gonna explode or it's gonna work or who knows. I don't care about LCD, I just wanted to charge the battery. If it charges the battery, then we can assume it is good. Just in case you will decide to turn on, let's put that on. That's our benchtop power supply. Voltage 1 volt. I have no idea what damage it will do. Okay. Okay. Voltage 5 volts. Voltage 10 volts. Anything? No, okay. Voltage 119 volts. Here we go. Should charge the battery at least. Weird behavior. Pressing the power button. It's a really messed up system now, okay. I'll just get its original charger. 19 volts is present there. Have about 9, not after the current sense resistor. Okay. There is no power in the system. Okay. I can't believe it. I'm guessing those MOSFETs also needs to be replaced by the looks of it. Yep, okay. Okay. I'm going to first remove these two MOSFETs. Short. So no short. Short is not there, okay. How about to ground? No short, okay. Okay, I should have replaced these two MOSFETs, okay. SM4839. SM4839, where the hell am I going to find these? Okay. SM4839, let me see. It's an in-channel, 30 volts, 12 amps, RDS on, 11.5, okay. Jesus, we're gonna find a replacement, okay. I have about 4835. Do I have that? No. I have about 4833. Okay. I've got nothing for SM48. Problem is, most of the MOSFETs I've got are the newer type. They're the flat type. Okay, let's continue the search again. unnecessarily long video. Like, none of these boards use that kind of MOSFET anymore. What is that? It's got individual legs, and it's got label of U, which is meaning it's a smart IC. It's not for power. Okay. Why would ASUS have used older type MOSFETs in this high-end laptop? It's because it's older generation. Okay. All right, you know what? I do have a box of older type of motherboards. Okay. And these guys have this type of MOSFET I will need. Let's check these ones. Wow, really? 4835D. Spot on, mate. Let me see, what do I need? What's this one? 4839. Okay. How about anything else on this? 4134. Let me check 4835D. Okay. P channel, no, we don't want that. Okay. How about these? These are 4134 MOSFET. In channel, okay. Thirty volts in channel and RDS on at 0.014, and the other one was 0.0115. It's very close. Should be all right. Should be okay. Okay, let's put these guys away. Okay, these two. Damn it, I don't remember the order. Okay. 1, 2, 3 is the source, 4th is the gate, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so just so it needs to go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then here. There we go. That's it. Put that there. Let's put him in. 4th is the gate. 5, 6, 7, 8 is the drain. Hope that will be it, eh? We turn it on, bang, the boys are dead. Let's see. Check the ground. Okay, no short at the moment. You never know. But look at that reading. How nice. Okay. How bizarre, okay. Voltage readings. What I would like to know is if there is 19 volts here or not. Just check if my ground is good in continuity. Yep. Okay. Voltage ready, set. Yes, we got a red light. Hallelujah. So a BQ chip, 2 MOSFETs, 1 resistor burned, plus the capacitor. Wow, that's some job right there. Okay. So it is not my fault with replacing a slightly different value capacitor. No, it has had bigger issues. That's for sure. Okay. So before we put all these back, I just need to review the video of where these tapes go. Unless I took a photo, let me see. So this guy went like this, okay. And this guy is supposed to go here, okay. What's that doing? Yeah, I need to upload. Okay. Hi. That. All right. Is this for the fan? Can't remember. Definitely one here, but that's not it. There should be one, three of them, probably these ones. So this guy had some weird hard drive holders. Could it be that these two belong here? Could be wrong. Okay. And then it's gonna go kaput. Just need to make sure none of the screw holes are covered. Yep, yep, yep. In the middle being there, okay. See if it will stay on. So we have that. And press the power, we have that. Well, that's bad. Oh, here we go. Maybe BIOS reset. But the BIOS CMOS battery was in the whole time. Okay. Well, that is bad because we don't have a screen. It's probably put into a hard drive already. Okay, let's turn it off. Okay. Improperly, like a maniac. Okay. So it should go into a repair mode. Yep, there we go. The BQ735, what's that? Yeah, let me double check. All right, great. Oh, beautiful background. I love it. So the system is currently on. I'm not sure how good the battery is. But I am gonna shut it down. And let it shut down. So it's currently off. I'm gonna go into BIOS. Okay, 3%. That's what I want to see. Okay. Okay, wonderful. Let's see if it goes up. Okay. And I'll go ahead and order this chip. Yeah, battery is charging, beautiful. And I'm gonna now disconnect the adapter. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it stays on. That's my main concern. Oh, it's the first generation. Oh, no, seventh generation. What's first? i7-7. No, it's 7700. Okay. Okay, that's okay. I thought it was like first generation. No way. Okay, so finally, that's all good. So thanks for watching. See you in the next one. This one was the crazy one.